In the next slides, I will give a bit more details per category. First, we will look at metals and their alloys. Metals are retrieved from the earth by mining. In the figure top left, you see this activity in an open mine pit. From rock, the iron has to be retrieved by the blast furnace process. In this process, very high temperatures are achieved, which melts the iron from the rock. The liquid metal is then purified. Unwanted elements are removed, and it is alloyed. Extra elements are added to the molten material to improve particular property. A similar process for aluminum is based on the electrolysis process. After purification and alloying, the molten metal has the right composition. It is casted and rolled in semi-finished products like sheet, plates, ingots, poles, blocks, etc. These semi-finished products are the input for manufacturing processes, which produces the required part or product. Metal alloys are well known and very good structural materials. They offer high strength and stiffness, are easy in production, both for low and high volumes, and are reasonably priced. Therefore, you can find them in numerous applications. If we confine ourselves to structures, then all major structural applications like ships, cars, bridges, aircraft, and a lot more can and have been made of metal alloys. The second category is polymers. Maybe not a category of materials for structural applications, though interesting, because it is one of the main ingredients for composites. They are macromolecular substances, built with high carbon-hydrogen-dominated molecules. There are two major classes. First, thermoplastics. They consist of large molecular chains that are not chemically bonded. The bonds between the chains are rather weak and can be broken when temperature is increased. This process is reversible. Second, thermosets are the other major polymer group, consisting of large molecular networks created by two or more chemical substances, monomers. Once cured and solidified, the network cannot be dissolved. Applications of polymers are abundant too. Look at the figures at the right-hand side of this slide and probably you can think of many more examples. One type of polymer not mentioned yet is the elastomer. On microstructural level, somewhat in between the thermoset and the thermoplastic polymers. Elastomers or rubbers are well known from car tires. Polymers can also be processed into fibers used in cloth and general industrial applications. The third category is ceramic materials. As already mentioned, these materials are often very brittle. They have a very limited ductility and, just like this dry riverbed, crack quite easily. The ceramic material is often made of oxides, nitrides, carbides, of silicium or carbon or combinations of them. Typical examples of ceramic materials are window panes, porcelain cups, saucers, bricks, etc. Because of their composition, ceramics can be very hard materials, ideal for cutting tools. And they have a good temperature resistance, used in thermal protection systems of space vehicles like the space shuttle. Despite these good characteristics, ceramics are not often used in typical structural applications because it lacks flexibility and ductility. The last category is composites. A definition is the following. Composites are engineering materials in which two or more distinct, structurally complementary substances, different physical or chemical properties, are combined to produce structural or functional properties not present in any individual component. Keywords in this definition are two or more, distinct, complementary, and not present in any individual component. Bringing together two different components creates a new combination having additional properties. There are two classes of composite: fiber-reinforced polymers and hybrid material. Fiber-reinforced polymers are polymers in which fibers are embedded in a matrix. The fibers are responsible for strength and stiffness. The polymer or matrix is responsible for the coherence, the load transfer between fibers, and for environmental protection. For the fibers, we can choose many different materials. Carbon, glass, and aramid fibers are often selected for aerospace applications. Other options might be metal fibers, polymer fibers like Dyneema, natural fibers like flax, and a lot more. Fibers can be purchased as short, long, and continuous fibers. And this fiber length has an important influence on the processing of composites. The second class are the hybrid materials. Now a third component is added, metal sheets. Such hybrids have alternating layers of fiber-reinforced polymers and metal sheets. Glare is a well-known hybrid material and is developed at the TU Delft. In this era, we are witnessing the transition from metal aircraft to composite aircraft. The latest designs of Boeing and Airbus, the 787 and the Airbus 350 respectively, are mainly made of composites. Both the wing and fuselage are made of carbon fiber reinforced polymers. Driving force for this change are the high specific properties, the different alternate manufacturing processes, and the prospect of cheaper aircraft.